me one of the query that you may have. So if you have attended yesterday, you can tell me, what is the use of Pega tool? What is the purpose of Pega tool?
To build.
It is used to develop applications. It's not only development. Applications will be developed, deployed, and executed on the same environment. Okay? And why they have given the name as Pega Systems for their organization? For the tool that they have developed, they have given the name Pega Rules Process Commander. Pega word is there. So what is the reason behind this? So the founder of Pega Systems is Alan Treffler. So Alan Treffler, this is the guy, I'm sorry. So this is the guy who is the owner of Pega Systems. See, if you go through Wikipedia and you just type in Google, list of world chess champions. He was one of the world chess champions during 1970s. So he started his career as a software engineer. At the age of 23, he has established an organization called Pega Systems. So before that, he was a chess champion, world chess champion. So during when he was world chess champion, there were two champions because of the tie during the finals. Okay, he was one among there was another guy, I don't remember the name. So he was one of the world chess champion, 1974 or maybe sometime, some duration. So his passion is chess. When he is establishing his organization, he wanted to give a name and logo to his organization, which always reflects his passion. When you look at the logo of his organization, Pega logo. I'm sorry. So this is Pega logo. So this is a knight. This is what looks like knight. What we use in chess. When you look at this, this one you call it as Pegasus. Actually, this is the logo. What you have is Pegasus. Pegasus is a horse with wings. This is the logo that has been taken, and out of Pegasus, he has taken the code Pega and named his organization Pega. Taken Pegasus logo. It's also similar to knight in chess, which always reflects his passion. So that is the reason behind giving the name as Pega System and Pega Rules Process Commander for the tool. And when it has been started, you can Google it and see it has been started officially 1983. Okay. Initially, when Pega has been started, whatever that we are discussing now, business logic in Core Java, it was in C language. Later, CPP, now it is Core Java. Okay, and what business sectors Pega is being used today? If you see in the market, can someone please know online resources? Mali, Matt. Yes, thank you very much. And what are the business sectors where you see Pega applications are running today? Let me name some of the business sectors. Banking. Let me name some of the clients: Bank of America, JP Morgan, Morgan Stanley, and we have many other different banks that are using. Coming to finance also same. And insurance, we have Hanover Insurance Group, we have Humana Healthcare, health insurance, something is there, and we have other insurance vendors also there. And healthcare, we have United Health Group, and we have United Health Group, and again Humana is there in healthcare, and different vendors are there. Pharma research, we have Roche Pharma, Pfizer, like this, different vendors are using pharmaceutical applications for research oriented applications. And automobile insurance, automobile sector, not insurance, automobile sector, we have Ford using Pega applications for one warranty applications. Suppose if you have a Ford vehicle today, and if you are going to submit your vehicle for some service during the warranty period, the application that they access is Pega application. Okay, and bench application, if you are going to rent a car in USA or any other countries, while you rent a car, after your rent period is completed, you can either purchase the car or you can return back. During this renting a car process will be handled by car rental process will be handled by Pega application from bench. Like this, there are different vendors in automobile sector. We have John Deere, heavy trucks and propliners, like heavy trucks, tractors, they're going to manufacture. For one of their internal application, they are using Pega. And telecommunications, we have Vodafone, and we have some client in Australia, OPS or something is there, and we have Verizon, and like this, there are many clients in telecommunication. Entertainment, we have Walt Disney using internal purpose, and Coming to retail domain, we have Amazon using applications for logistic maintenance. For their logistic, suppose if you're purchasing a product in Amazon, nowhere you see this one, Pega application. But when you try to select a product today, you add it to cart, price is 10 rupees, let's say. After 10 days, if you're trying to check out the product, it says, dispatchable, the price has been updated. This price will be retrieved by their logistics maintenance. That logistic maintenance application is Pega application. It's not only price and number of products, whatever it is. So internal applications. So what type of business applications that we're going to develop using Pega? As I've already told you, Pega licensing cost is high and it is with respect to number of users going to access the application as well. So mainly Pega is used for intranet applications, that is back operations applications. The business users are also employees of organizations, meaning that back operations teams. Okay. And Pega is cost effective, but still why Pega is leading the market? The reason is because of its error-free processing, automation of development. So your development cost and maintenance cost is less when you buy Pega product. And what are the versions of Pega? I'm not going to write down everything here. Just simply let me version, as far as I remember, version 4, 4.1, 5.1, Service Pack 1, Service Pack 2, 5.5, Service Pack 1, 2. From here onwards, two service packs. 5.5 after 6.1, 6.2, 6.3. And Pega 7. From 7 onwards, 7.1, 7.1.1, 1.2, 1.3, like that, 7.2, 7.2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 7.3. After 7.3, I'm not very much sure patch is available or not. 7.4. After 7.4, 8.1. That is what we are going to work today. Okay, 8.1 is not there in the market today. Few companies are using 8.1. But if you learn 8.1, but damn sure by May or June, most of the applications will be running on 8.1. Okay, if you're going to join any organization today, you might be working on 7.2 or 3 or 4 or 8.1. If you learn 8.1, you should be able to work on either of these before versions. That is how we are going to see. And while working, while we are going to learn it, I'm also going to mention some of the points related to difference between Pega 6 version and Pega 7 version. Okay, that also I'll tell you.
I have a question and, here.
Yes, what is the question?
Actually, in my
be a bit louder.
Actually, in my company, they are using 6.3 version. So, yes, how does it differ?
Yeah, I will tell you the differences.
How... Okay.
While we are working, I'll tell you how Pega 7 is different compared to 6 version. Up to Pega 6, it is one era of Pega. From Pega 7 onwards, it has been more stabilized. Okay, and I'll tell you the differences later. What are the certifications available in Pega? As I have already mentioned yesterday, I'm not very much sure, but let me tell you. There are certain certifications as a developer that you have to complete. CSC, listen to this carefully. CSSC, Certified Senior System Architect, LSA. This is not required for anyone who is going to learn here. Okay, if you're going to start your career as a resource in Pega, this is not required as of. Our course will cover both levels of certification content, topics and all. See, as a developer, if you want to apply for a job, Pega PRPC job, you must be certified. Without certification, you're not allowed to get into any job. So you should be certified CSA beginner. This is beginner level, this is senior level. Certified system architect, certified senior system architect. Everyone must have to complete CSA for sure. Okay. If you are a number of people who are going to join here, who are going to apply for a job, everyone must complete. This is mandatory. CSA is mandatory if you are from any other country other than India. If you are from USA and other countries, remember this, for you, by default, CSA, CSSA is mandatory. Okay. Other than India, any country, Singapore, Malaysia, Australia, any country. The requirements what you see is mostly on CSSA. In India also. I'm not going to talk about your experience level and all. Whatever your experience is in Pega or overall. Okay. If your expected CTC is 7 plus lakhs. I'm not talking about your current CTC. Your expected CTC is 7 lakhs plus. You must be CSSA certified. Okay. Because they have certain slabs defined in each organization. For CSA, this is the payment that you have to do, CSSA. I'm not talking about your experience level. Pega, you are 3, 4, overall you are 5, 6, whatever it is. You are overall 2 years only. Your expected CTC is 8 lakhs. Then mostly you will be expected to be a CWSA developer for that package to be given. Okay, this is clear, everyone. Next, what certification that you have to complete as a developer? This is what I have told you. As a student, what should be your expectation? This I will cover later. 11th question, we'll leave it now. We'll come back to the question later. These are some of the queries related to technical. Let me complete the general queries as well. So general queries, you might have these queries in your mind, like who is eligible to learn Pega? Today you might be working in IT in any organization, or you might not be working. Whether you are working or not, no matter. You can learn Pega and you can apply for Pega job. So showing some experience, like 1 year, 2 years, 3 years on Pega, you have to apply for a job. If your background is education background, coming to education background, second question, it can be anything. It can be degree, normal degree or technical degree. You are from B Pharmacy, M Pharmacy, or from MBA. If you're going to show experience on Pega as an experienced resource in IT industry, they won't bother about your degree and all. So any degree is eligible. Okay, that is about education background. And what are the technical prerequisites to start learning Pega? So you can start learning Pega as a new programmer, new learner for programming, but you're not write any code here. So what everyone, I suggest you go through YouTube and try to watch videos about in some of the channels. I'm not very much sure about what channel. Go to YouTube. What is a class in Java? What is inheritance? Concepts. We need to know concepts. You're not required to know syntaxes and some technical details you're not required to know. But concept wise, what do you mean by a class? What do you mean by inheritance? These two you should understand theoretically. That is fair enough. Today you can complete this. You can go through any channel. Maybe many people would have been explained in YouTube. Go through the videos, complete this today and tomorrow, so that you can easily cope up understanding Pega, classes and inheritance. These are generic concepts. Okay, remaining are not required. Other OOPS concepts are not required. If you are already aware of these things, that is fair enough. If you do not know about this, because it is a theoretical concept, everyone without any technical background also should be able to understand what is class, what is inheritance, and what are the job opportunities in today's market. So there are a number of job opportunities, but you will not see any much openings till you get election results in India, for sure. There are pretty less openings now, but after the results are declared, after government formation is completed, obviously you'll see any business is being again kick-started. So you'll see a number of openings in the market. In US and other countries, there are a number of openings, okay? So there are a number of opportunities. Compared to resources, opportunities are more. As opportunities are more, they're not going to hire everyone, whoever is going to attend the interview. You should be technically good, remember that. So remember this clearly. If you join any project, you do not expect that you are going to be on bench for 1 month or 2 months, and then you will be given KT for 15 days, 20 days, and then you will be assigned with work. You join today, you will be given with a laptop, you will be given with work. You have to start working on the application, understanding by yourself, doing research by yourself. No one is going to give you KT and all. It may happen or it may not happen. Okay, so you should, with this training itself, you should be like a ready to work developer. You should be like a developer who is going to ready to work on any application that is given to you. On spot, you have to analyze the application and work on the business requirement, understanding. That's how you should mold yourself. That's how you have to gain the knowledge. That's why we have training duration is almost 2.5 months plus 1 week. So should I have to be certified in Pega? I think this is covered. You must have to be certified. Can I get help in resume preparations and certifications? All this, definitely I'll help you on resume preparations, provide explanations, interview questions, and some techniques that you have to follow. And your certifications also, I'll help you. And I have a few dumb questions and that I can share you. And technical knowledge, what we are learning here also will help you to clear the certification. And apart from that, there are other types of help, which I will tell you later. Okay. So make sure that you're going to, I'll make sure that you're going to pass the exam on first go itself. What is the duration of the course? As you already know, 2.5 months is the duration of the course. Take 1 week more than that, for sure. And why the duration is too long here, when you are seeing this duration is 45 days like the other institutions is, it's not because of the course content that I'm going to cover. Same content we can cover or anyone can cover within 1 month or 1.5 months. It's about the implementation that we are going to do. The same content I can teach you with basic top level understanding within 1 month. Same content giving you dynamic implementation, like every topic with real time scenarios, it will take some time. That's why your duration is a little longer compared to other institutions, because we are going to work on business requirements on every topic, implementing it practically, okay, included in an application. See, we are not going to provide you any recordings. What if you're going to miss a class? Suppose today you're not able to attend your class on emergency. There are some things. See, we're going to provide you theory plus practical documents. Theory document, practical documents with screenshots. If you missed any class, your class will be compensated with other batch. There won't be any batches running parallel later. You must have to intimate me before if you're going to miss the class, or at least after you miss the class, you just give a WhatsApp message that you have not attended today's class. Even though whether you attend or not, you'll be receiving the theory plus practical documents on your email inbox for sure. Okay, and I'll make sure that you are going to understand next class by providing you the content in some other ways, because there are certain videos, there are some videos which are already available in YouTube channel, but not every video is there. There are some videos already available in my YouTube channel about few topics, explanation and all. I may recommend to watch one of the video so that you can understand next class and cope up with the next class. But your classes will be compensated. So are we going to build any project? Let me complete all these questions, then you can ask me if you have any questions. Are we going to build any project from the scratch? Yes, we're going to work on building a project from the scratch. We're going to work on two projects. One project I'm going to teach you from the scratch. Your technology will be taught. Theory, practical, implementation, screenshot, documents, everything of one project. Second project, I'm going to give you only requirements document. You have to read the requirements. You have to understand the requirement. Imagine the implementation. You have to implement it on your own. Okay. So that is how the second project. So are we going to provide any soft copy of the material? Yes. Soft copy of theory plus practical documents of your classes will be provided. Okay. And how should I work on my practical business requirements? We are going to follow certain classes. Listen to this carefully. Everyone who is going to join this batch will be finalized by Monday. Okay, that means your fees payments have to be done by this Friday evening. Okay, so whoever is going to join this batch by completing your fees payments by Friday evening or by Saturday evening, mostly. If you have already talked to me that you are going to pay it on Monday, that is okay. Not see after Monday evening, you have to wait on your joining if you have not completed your fees payment. Okay, this is clear. Now, whoever is going to be joining this batch will be adding them into WhatsApp group. I'm going to create a group in WhatsApp, where all the students of your batch will be there. Your batch number 566, I believe. Okay. So there will be a name. I'll just let you know all that. Okay. So you'll be added into the group. And after we complete creation of the group, I'll be asking you to give your mail ID. Once your mail ID is provided, everyone on a single go, I'm going to create a email group. Your documents will be shared to you on your email group, email. Okay. Once after your class is completed, it will be there in your mailbox. So you have to go through the documents, theory, practical, both. You have to practice from your end. During the class, we don't need any laptop. During the class, if you're joining online, maybe you need a laptop to join the class session, but we don't need your laptop to access PRPC development environment. So you will be listening to the class, understanding, and then after the class is completed, you have to practice maybe immediately after the class or maybe evening or sometime later once you get the time. But it must be completed on the same day. Okay. So today class by tomorrow must be completed. You should have proper schedule for the same. And that is how you have to plan. And what kind of procedure that you are going to follow for practical sessions? The process is, during your practicals, if you stuck anywhere, if you are facing any issues, errors, you have to communicate in the WhatsApp group about your issues that you are facing. You should not send me a WhatsApp message. You should not be calling me directly, because it will be difficult to handle these many people if each individual is calling. So the idea behind the group is, you are going to coordinatively work together. Your issue will be resolved by someone else who is going, who is learning along with you parallelly. Okay, you can coordinatively work together in order to implement your business requirements and all. That is the main purpose of the group. And suppose if you are from USA, you will be practicing your daytime, which will be nighttime for me. Maybe you will be practicing your nighttime. Maybe from other countries, time zones might not be matching. But there are resources who will be there along with you, joining from your country. If you are from India, you're practicing at morning time or something, there will be people from India who are going to respond to you. If you are from USA and your time is for practicing, there will be people. So you can coordinatively work together. All time zone resources can communicate. So definitely you'll have someone to respond for sure. During night time in India, if I am not available, definitely there will be people from USA in your batch itself, in your group itself, who is going to help you for sure. Okay. And this is the process that we're going to follow. And how far, so everyone have to register in my website called Harsha Trainings, which I will tell you tomorrow. You'll be having access to that website for lifetime. I'll tell you tomorrow what kind of support you're going to get after the training is getting completed. I'll be available anytime, even during the training duration or after the training, maybe after 1 year or 2 years. Anytime you can give a message on WhatsApp or call me if you're looking for any guidance on Pega. Okay. So these are some of the queries that you may have. Apart from these queries, if you have any other queries, you can ask me now. Tomorrow I'll tell you where you have to download the software from and how to proceed with installation guide and all. I'll tell you tomorrow. Otherwise, if you wanted to go ahead now, you can go ahead and note down in your notebook. Everyone go to this website, Harsha Trainings. Okay, no need to note down. I'll send you a document. The document clearly says how to register, how to download software and all. I'll share you the document which talks about registration process in this website and where to go to download the software and all. And make sure you're going to download Pega 8.1 version. There are two softwares available in this. 7.4, 8.1. 8.1. In the instructions document, even though it says download 7.4 something, you ignore that and download 8.1. I'll correct it and send you. I'll send you one more document, one or two more documents, which will give you a clear idea about where to register in which website, where is the software available, and how to download it. And another document of installation instructions. If you blindly follow the installation instructions, you should be able to install the software. If you have basic idea about computer, that's how instructions are written. And remember one thing, it cannot be installed on Mac OS. You need Windows operating system. Okay? It will not support Mac OS home version. It will support only Windows Linux. If you have Mac, you can install VMware and install Windows on VMware and then install it on. Class, just one more question, hang on. Classes are weekdays, same time every day, Monday to Friday. Sometimes classes will be there Saturday. I intimate you 1 or 2 weeks before accordingly. This Saturday we have for other batches. For first two Saturdays, there won't be any class for you. Okay. So that's how it will be. I will post the walk. I'll send you the documents till Monday. Till I create WhatsApp group, I'll be sharing an email group. From Tuesday onwards, you'll be receiving everything on your Gmail. Till Tuesday morning, you'll be receiving everything on your personal WhatsApp. That is in broadcast. Okay. And system requirements and all is given in the document. Someone else online is asking question. What is that? I'll send you personal WhatsApp.
Yeah, sir, that is regarding that minimum requirement, system requirement. So you said that
that is there in the document, which I am going to share you. Minimum requirements, if you want to tell now, like 4 GB RAM minimum, Windows 8 or 10 operating system would be good, and 20 GB minimum hard disk space. Okay.
It's a 32-bit or 64-bit.
6 or 8 GB RAM, better. Sorry.
32-bit or 64-bit laptop should be there.
Sorry, I have to mention this. Operating system should be 64-bit OS. Mostly today are 64-bit OS. If not, format it and install 64-bit operating system. It do not support 32-bit. Clear? So you can ask me any other queries. Tomorrow also we're going to join for query session. If you have any other queries other than what we have discussed so far, you can ask me. You can start from now. Till next 7 minutes, you can ask me if you have any queries. Most of the queries are sorted, but still.
Yeah, so I have a question.
Personal, okay, we have a question offline, just hang on. Personal edition is how it is different from enterprise version. Your enterprise edition of PRBC and personal edition are same. Windows OS, personal edition, home version, and enterprise version. Both are more or less same. But distribution wise, installing on clusters and all, some components will not be available here in this one. And some components are missing, but that is not required actually for a developer. Okay, that is only for admins. Okay, and someone else online is asking a question. Only one person unmuted and just asked.
Yes, I have a question. So I have been working on all the public facing applications till date and for now also. So in that case, how will Pega be useful for me? Like if I start learning Pega, like we don't have any internal applications or something, it's all public facing. So is there anywhere we can public facing ways where other customers are using it? So I work for a transport company where the other external users are booking their loads or something like shipping.
No. Retail applications will not be developing in Pega generally, but you can mention any other application. No, see, your organization has Pega or not doesn't matter. You're technically good or not, it is the matter.
Okay, so is there no way we can implement Pega there, right?
Yeah, you can implement, no issues. Someone else is asking a question online. Are you going to post demo recorded sessions on WhatsApp? I have already sent yesterday demo video. Old video that was already sent it yesterday. If you have not received, give a WhatsApp. Send it
again. Regarding certification, I have a question.
Regarding certification?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Is it mandatory to complete CSA and then CSSA, or we can directly?
Yes, the certification should be done in the same order. If you are done with CSA, then only you are eligible for booking CSSA. It should be done like that. Without completing CSA, you can't go with CSA.
So after completion of CSA, can we do immediately or do we have to wait?
Immediately. There is no official time gap defined by Pega system. You complete CSA now, on the same system you book CSSA immediately and write it tomorrow. It is okay.
Actually, I have 4 GB RAM in my machine. Is that okay or I need to upgrade to 8 GB?
We have till tomorrow also, we have time if I'm not going to address your queries today. And 4 GB RAM is also okay, but your application will be a little slow. Better you increase the RAM, you buy one more RAM and install in the slot. It will work
right now for as per temporary purpose, right now is it okay, right? For few days.
Yes, it is okay. It will run, but it will be slow. That is what I'm saying. And any other questions?
I have a question regarding this job opportunity. Yes. Is it mandatory to show some experience of Pega? If I am working on some other domain and I am learning Pega now, will I be able to apply for Pega jobs?
Yes, you should be able to apply for Pega job mentioning your experience on Pega. You must have to show experience on Pega if you are going to apply for Pega job. Remember that.
Okay.
That's why you are learning Pega. Otherwise, they can hire even some other freshers as well. 1 year, 2 years. You apply for freshers also, we have some openings. But that is for fresher graduates. Suppose you are working on mainframes or .NET since past 3 years or 2 years, and you want to apply as a fresh developer in Pega, no one is going to take you. You are a fresher graduate, then you can apply. That is okay. Okay.
Okay.
Anyone else has any other questions online?
Yes, sir. I have a question here.
Yes.
Yes, this question is based on yesterday's discussion. Actually, in Pega, everything is integrated, you know, like a database, a servers, everything. But to drive those rules. Integrated in the Pega.
Every application is integrated, it's not only in Pega. Yeah. Technology, so, database, application servers are integrated. Same concept.
We no need to install separately, you know, database,
see,
everything.
No, that is here in home version. See, in your Pega, everything is integrated. Similarly, other technologies also, everything is integrated. During installation of home version, on a single click, all will be installed. Enterprise, it is not like that. You have to install separately, that you will not do. Some someone else is going to do.
Okay.
What is predefined in Pega is product is predefined, code is predefined related to UI, logic, and queries. And data in the database is some data in database also predefined.
Yeah, that's
so
what you
will come up with empty.
So this case we need separate interface to drive those rules like a BRA.
Sorry,
BRA? That a business rule engine. No? So that is used for to drive those rules into
business rules engine process. Is writing the rules into database, bringing the rules from database. This is a product predefined. It is provided by Pegasystems. That is what you have product business rules engine.
That's my question is, do we need that to drive those rules since it's already integrated in Pega, no?
It is already integrated in Pega. We will create new rules as well. We will see that. Okay. You may not be able to clearly understand what is a rule technically. Later you are going to understand.
Okay.
Functionally, if you understand, that is fair enough as of now. Okay, it's 9 o'clock. We have to wind up. So tomorrow completely you can ask me any queries. Note down what are the queries that you have. Okay, we will address it tomorrow from the beginning. Maybe first half an hour we'll discuss about all the questions. Later, next half an hour, I'll tell you what are we going to work on. Right? Tomorrow we're going to start working on this. Okay. So by tomorrow, everyone should complete the installation. Okay, remember this. Do not delay it. I'll be sharing you the document today itself. Complete today itself. Okay. You can wind up for today. We'll continue tomorrow. As I have asked you, give a WhatsApp message on my WhatsApp number 9652532753 if you're not receiving any messages from me, so that you'll receive the documents. If you want to talk to me, you can call me after 11 o'clock. No need to give me a message on WhatsApp requesting for my permission. Can I call you something? Call me after 11 o'clock. I'll call you back if I'm not able to pick the call after some time. Okay, fine. You can wind up for today. Thank you for joining. Those who has joined for 8 o'clock demo class, online resources, must exit the meeting, must exit auto meeting.